exactly does that favor Trump? How much does that get him back in here? That's the question in a place like Mahoney. But it really varies by county. Ohio right now, you know, some have a lot more the same day, some have a lot more than they have. So that here, but again, 13,000, that's Biden's advantage. And we'll just check in and see what the number is in North Carolina right now. It's sitting at about 80,000 in North Carolina.
Steve Bernanke, thank you. We're going to bring into the conversation our colleague Mike Memoli, who covers the Biden campaign for us. Mike Memoli, this Biden campaign is not prone to a lot of mood swings. They went 0-3 in the first three Democratic primaries.
Okay, that was nice.
My sense is there
was a surprise. Okay, that was a surprise too. Very nice, very nice. Well, that can help.
From the very beginning, has always been playing the long game. Now, for anybody who's looking to Florida to provide some early news and quick results that would trend in Biden's direction, that's not happening. The Biden campaign, outside Democratic sources, are conceding that that state is trending in the wrong direction. The problem, of course, they see it as a unique problem of Cuban American vote for President Trump is too strong for Biden to carry the statewide vote. The good news that they see in Florida, though, indications of the urban vote, the non-Cuban Latino vote, also strong. That is a good indication for states like Arizona for the Biden.